the JAMA Network.
Hello, I'm Dr. Harley Goldberg, the director of the Spine Care Program at Kaiser Permanente, Northern California. We, of course, have a lot of patients with spine problems, including herniated discs and acute radiculopathy. And over the years, we have moved, as many have, from the surgical treatment to the interventional treatment. And it has been my observation clinically that people would get better with oral prednisone, as well as, perhaps, epidural steroid injections. So because of that, we underwent the randomized double-blind clinical trial of oral prednisone versus placebo for acute radiculopathy associated with a herniated lumbar disc. We randomized nearly 300 patients. It was 269 patients that were adult patients enrolled in the Kaiser Permanente program who presented with clinical acute radiculopathy and who were found also to be confirmed with a positive MRI that matched clinically their clinical presentation. They had a physical exam, and then we used outcome instruments that included the Oswestry Disability Index and the Visual Analog Scale, as well as subsets of the SF-36 and other global questionnaires as well. We studied whether or not oral prednisone in a 2-to-1 randomization with placebo would improve pain and increase function in this patient population. The results were no different between the randomized patients to placebo and those with prednisone in terms of pain over the first 3 weeks and, in fact, at any point in the time course out to 52 weeks. We did find a statistically significant benefit in functional improvement, but it was of minimal clinical improvement. That is to say, it was less than 7 points on a 100-point Oswestry scale. While our data set contains a lot more data for us to evaluate and determine perhaps other aspects of non-invasive treatment, other medications, or other methods of care that may or may not be appropriate for this population, what was surprising to us was that the oral prednisone did not, in fact, decrease the pain as we expected. Our next steps will be to evaluate how these patients rolled over to an epidural steroid injection, to a surgical outcome, and or the use of other concomitant pain medications throughout the course of this study to let us infer what would be the next studies needed to find the optimal non-invasive treatments for this population. What this trial does not answer is the non-specific effects of placebo. This trial does not have a normal treatment arm, so we do not know actually what is the non-specific effect of the placebo treatment. And that is one more question that is yet to be answered, as in any other placebo-controlled trial.